Ahead of Pastor Ok Su Park's Bible Seminar in May, Bible seminars are being actively conducted by region. The Good News Ilson Church invited Pastor Jungi Lim from the 23rd to the 26th and held a Bible seminar with the theme of It Is God Who Justifies, and Wonju Church held a Bible seminar with Pastor Hoyun Hong as a lecturer during the same period under the theme of True Light Comes to the World and Shines on Everyone. Bible seminars were held and many attendees received salvation through the word and individual religious counseling. On the 28th and 29th, the Russian-speaking team of Incheon Church held a Bible seminar with Pastor Lim Hong Soon at the Russian-speaking center and touched the hearts of the participants with words, praises, and testimonies. Dongdaemun Church invited Good News Anson Church and Pastor Sang Jun Lee to hold a Bible seminar, watch the history of the gospel spreading all over the world through videos, and give glory to God who lives and works through testimonies and words. Bible seminars were also actively held in Chuncheng, Jeonbuk, and Daegu. The Good News Daejeon Church held the Bible seminar with Pastor Sewon Kim from the 24th to the 27th. Cheongju Church carried out evangelism activities in various ways, such as installing 18 unmanned kiosks in downtown Cheongju while holding a Bible seminar with Pastor Yeonggon Kang, and about 50 new people attended the seminar. At Namdejian Church, Pastor Bai Jong-gun Bible Seminar was held and street evangelism was conducted, and about 30 people heard the gospel among the abundant programs. Gunsan Church held a Bible seminar with Pastor No Yong Jo, and the chapel was filled with seniors from Silver University and invited participants in various ways. The Good News Suzhong Church also held a Bible seminar with Pastor Cho Seong-hwa to preach the gospel to the citizens, and it became an opportunity to have greater hope for Pastor Oxa Park's Bible seminar to be held in Daegu in May. Meanwhile, in Liberia, regular KELF meetings are held at the end of each month at established churches. At the regular meeting held on the 25th, about 50 external pastors and leaders gathered, and at the meeting, which was moderated by Rev. Eric Barley, the leader of the Liberia Church Association, Rev. Seongji Kim of the Malovian Church of Deep News preached the gospel. The ministers shouted Amen, convinced of the remission of their sins. Most of the pastors who attended the KELF conference are receiving salvation. Good News Anson Church Youth Association held Yaikiel with Africa on the 22nd. Yaikiel is an abbreviation for Young Christian Leaders, a group of young Christian leaders, and this meeting was prepared for Christian Africans attending Korean classes. The event proceeded in the order of dance, overseas, volunteer work, experience groups, and recreation. In particular, the African a cappella performance received a warm response from the participants. The lecturer, Pastor Song Jun Lee, preached the gospel using the words of Romans 3:24 and conveyed his hope for studying abroad in Korea. After Atlanta, the LA KELF World Conference, which filled pastors all over the world with the gospel, was held for 4 days from April 17th to the 20th in the Grand Ballroom of the Sheraton Hotel in San Gabriel, USA. With this LCF World Conference, the LA Church carried out various promotional activities starting from the monthly pastors' prayer meeting. Among them, 8 pastors prepared this LA conference together as KELF executives, and other pastors opened the way for them to preach the gospel in the Sunday worship services of their churches. In addition, more pastors than ever wanted to attend the KELF, including pastors who were connected through the Mind Rally and pastors who met the evangelism team to share the gospel and build friendships. On the evening of the 17th, the opening ceremony with the Grotches Choir announced the start of the KELF conference, and the schedule began in earnest on the 18th. In this conference, exchanges between pastors took place every morning and evening under the name of Coffee and Fellowship. Mind education, youth ministry, couple counseling. At a table with themes of church growth and the tabernacle, pastors talked with each other according to their interests and shared their thoughts about faith and ministry. The main conference was held twice a day, morning and evening, with lectures by Pastor Ok Soo Park and performances by the Gracious Choir. Congratulations and prayers from Christian leaders from around the world and pastors from all over the United States. Through this KELF, they express their hope that pastors will restore pure faith based on the only truth, the Bible, and America will become one before God, not based on denominations and denominations. On the evening of the 19th, Bishop Ahmed Kenneth Kwasi, president of the Independent Methodist Church in Ghana, delivered a congratulatory speech. After hearing the gospel for the first time in 2017, he said that his life and ministry had completely changed, and he expressed his gratitude to Pastor Ok Soo Park, who taught true faith and led them to the Lord. Pastor Ok Soo Park arrived in LA on the 18th after a meeting with Guatemalan President Alejandro Zamate. In this main conference, the gospel of Jesus, who died on the cross for the sins of the world, was preached, starting with the sin offering of Leviticus. Because Jesus died for our sins, we can no longer be sinners. I emphasize that I should believe in Jesus who washed my sins, not Jesus who could not wash away my sins. On the 19th, the EF Leaders Forum was held for community leaders who want to lead the next generation through the Bible. About 180 leaders from all walks of life, including 16 city council members from 11 cities around LA and consuls from 11 countries, gathered at the Leaders Forum, which was held for the fifth time. Prior to the ceremony, plaques of appreciation were presented to YF founder Pastor Ok Soo Park in San Gabriel and Monterey Park. San Gabriel Deputy Mayor John Wu and Mayor Jessica Martinez Whittier paid tribute to the hard work of the EF and Pastor Ok Soo Park, who are dedicated to youth education and teaching God's love for youth who are confused in cultural and social conflicts through congratulatory remarks. During the Mind presentation to introduce EF Mind Education to the attendees, EF founder Pastor Ok Soo Park assured the attendees that they could lead the youth away from evil thoughts and into a happy path through the Bible to the attendees who felt the need for mind education as a fundamental solution to youth problems. Did. During this KELF conference, Pastor Ok Soo Park met and interviewed representative-level pastors from around the world at dawn and before and after the main conference. As a generation that experienced the Korean War, Pastor Park personally expressed his gratitude to the United States for helping him a lot during the war, then explained the process of forgiveness of sins through the Bible and preached the gospel of Jesus who made us whole and holy. On the evening of the 20th, the last day, announcing the end of the LA KELF World Conference, the Easter Cantata of the Gracious Choir took place. The death and resurrection of Jesus Christ that took place in Israel 2,000 years ago made us deeply engrave the message of the gospel that was preached throughout this KELF conference, the love of Jesus Christ who died and forgave all sins for us. Lastly, Pastor Ok Soo Park delivered the message that if the Holy Spirit descends on our hearts that have been made completely righteous by the blood of Jesus Christ, and then we rely on God whenever we face difficulties, God will help us amazingly. And since the American mission of the Good News mission is not just to make Christians, but to make Christians who believe in Jesus and receive the forgiveness of sins, they conveyed their hope and vision for American missions to share the gospel together. The right direction for pastors to go. The 2023 LA KELF World Conference made us accept the gospel of the eternal forgiveness of sins accomplished by Jesus Christ and engrave our mission to spread it throughout the world. We look forward to seeing how the KELF's amazing move, which is changing the United States, will unfold in the United States for the rest of the year.